Okay.
Okay.
Thank you so much for being with us on Sonopleur TV.
My pleasure.
Yeah. I'm kind of ashamed to ask you this question, but for the younger generation who doesn't know you,
yeah.
Could you introduce yourself, your band, your music?
Sure. My name is Thomas Youngblood. I'm from the band Camelot. I'm the guitar player, and I started the band a few years back, and we're symphonic metal mixed with all kinds of genres. So it's something for everybody.
Yeah. There is a very cinematographic vibe on your music.
Yeah, I mean, we always try to paint some sort of cinematic picture with our music and also lyrics. We want that to convey some sort of story or some kind of ideas that we have about, you know, the things that we, way we think about certain things in life, whether it be religion or politics. We like to use a lot of metaphors in that, that aspect.
Religion seemed to be... I don't know if I can say an issue for you, but in your last video, Lie, you created a world, a dystopic world,
yeah,
with a religious figure who trying to control everything. Is that a fear for you, or?
Well, I mean, I think that should be something everyone's concerned with, whether you're a religious person or not. I mean, we can see the role that religion plays in life today. You know, here it is, 2015, and still. It's a massive influence on people, whether it be in the Middle East or even in the United States, with the way that things are being done, whether it be in the government. I mean, we try to always separate government from religion, but it's very difficult when you have people that are actually in the government that are very religious, you know. And it's an important thing, though, that we have in the U.S. is the separation of church and state, which you know, at some point is really going to be crucial. If a certain another religion, for example, grows in the U.S. and the other religions don't like it, you know what I mean? So it's important to keep that separate.
Okay, cool. So you're here tonight in Paris for how many times have you played in Paris?
Oh, I don't know. I think we played at least 10, I guess.
It's 10 times.
Yeah, okay. And so, yeah, so we're excited. It's a beautiful theater here in Paris, and we haven't played here, I don't think, in maybe 2 or 3 years. So we're excited.
Mm. Yeah, and you are here to promote Heaven. Could you describe to us the main themes of this album?
Well, like we were talking about, we really tried to paint this more future modern kind of dystopic world, and we can kind of see the human kind of evolution going towards this, you know, whether it be with the way we treat the environment and also technology taking over, you know, that there's a picture of people walking with their cell phones, and there's a whole bunch of them, and you can and it's like the zombie apocalypse is actually now, you know.
Yeah.
So that whole kind of thing is prevalent in society, and you could see that evolving into something that I think could be destructive if we don't kind of, you know, get back to the simple things in life, you know, nature and actually reading a real book, writing real letters, that kind of thing.
Doesn't it bother you in shows when you see all your fans going
with their phones?
Yeah.
But what do you know, it's a little bit douchey to say, hey, please put your phones down, because so if people want to do that, I'd rather that the peer pressure from other people in the crowd dictate what happens there, you know.
Yeah.
For me, it's just irritating that, you know, you're living your life through this screen instead of just experiencing the concert.
Yeah.
And that goes for everything, you know, just like people walking around or in public and they're just constantly looking at their phones. And it's like, get out, live your life. Don't live it through the phone.
Yeah, there is actually a lot of bands who send me that, who send me this.
We'll probably see it a lot because we travel so much, you know.
About your cinematographic universe, if I can say this. Is there any directors who influence you? Or
I like a lot of the sci-fi stuff, personally. Mm. I wouldn't say specific directors, but I went through a big kick when I was younger, like being into sci-fi movies and TV shows, like Logan's Run, I really liked. There's a movie called Gattaca that I love. It's like one of my favorites. And The Island, for example. Mm. So we use a lot of those kind of ideas too for the new videos. And But that's kind of the theme we wanted to go for. And we were lucky to have a director down in Serbia that was able to kind of fulfill those visions.
As a sci-fi fan, do you wait for the next Star Wars?
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah. Absolutely, it's going to be awesome. Yeah. And I have a 5-year-old son now, so I'm going to take him, you know, and hopefully it's not too violent.
Yeah, yeah, we'll see. about the show tonight, could you speak to us about the guys who are with us, with you, Cobra and Gus G?
Yeah, Gus G has been a friend of ours for many years. They Firewind toured with us. Mm. Actually, we played in Paris with Firewind once. And we've kept in touch over the years, even after he got the Ozzy gig, you know, and we were able to come see Ozzy and go backstage. And so we've been friends for many years, and he's always, his band always puts on a killer show. And Cobra and the Lotus is a band that we heard about when we were in the U.S. They're from Canada. Mm. My buddy Bill Hudson, who is playing guitar for them, so that's kind of how I found out about them as well. So we thought it'd be a perfect package for the European tour.
Cool. Are you working on new materials, or for the moment you are on the...
No, the album's only been out like 5-6 months now, so...
Yeah, that's
right. I'm starting to think about stuff, but we have another U.S. tour coming up in November, December. Then we're probably going to come back to Europe in April next year.
Okay.
Then we'll do summer festivals. So probably after the summer next year, we'll start working on new ideas and things.
Right. No, I actually thinking of sci-fi stuff. what Star Wars did you see the Star Trek movies by J.J. Abrams?
I saw a few of them, but not as many as I want to go back and start watching them, because I've actually been looking at the original Star Trek.
Yeah.
We have a channel in the U.S. that shows all the vintage TV shows, so I started looking at the original Star Trek. Now I want to start catching up with all the movies and everything.
And you are more a fan of the about Star Wars? Are you more a fan of the trilogy or the original trilogy?
The original stuff is my favorite. Yeah, I mean, it's very hard to, you know. For example, with albums, you know, when people do part two or part three, it almost never measures up to the original. You know, and we actually did an album called Epica, and after that, we were going to do another record called Epica 2, and I was totally against using part two. And so we named it the Black Halo.
Okay.
And in hindsight, that was perfect because it has its own spirit, even though it's the second part of this concept. So, yeah. So I'm always pretty much fans of the original stuff, you know.
Yeah. They're the best, actually. I think too. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Really.
Have fun tonight.
Yeah. You too.
Thanks.
Nice gig and break a leg.
Awesome.